Hello and welcome back. This is Fleece and this is another Skyrim video. We're going to check in on our Templar and see how things are going. Only one thing really has changed since we captured our Moth Priest. I took some of the gear and I redid her armor. I got her the Dawnguard armor. I thought it looked really nice. I thought it blended in well, and it's time that she had a little armor to back her up until we can get, you know, either something better for the gauntlets and boots, or something like that. She's always going to have a hood on, so, you know, it's going to take a while to get something better for that, but we've got her a little bit of armor, a little more protection, because, I mean, she does have a sword, and, you know, she does do melee combat occasionally. And we went ahead and put the, restoration, costs 5% less, and magic regenerates 10% faster, back on this particular piece of armor. We're back at Castle Volkohar. We were attacked by two Dawnguard scouts, which is where I get more Dawnguard armor at. I'm going to have a lot of that. But we're going to go turn the quest in and see what this Moth Priest has to say. And then get into some really fun stuff.
Well done. Somehow I knew it would be you who found our Moth Priest.
Yes, I see that. I trust his capture was not true. I wish I could have been there to hear the sounds of their screams. Well, your thrall awaits, and we have given him the Elder Scroll. Command him to read it, and let us hear the words of prophecy.
And here's my thrall.
Master, I have done as you asked and traveled here. Of course, what is it that you need? Ah, yes, the Elder Scroll. I admit, of course, Master. Now, if everyone will please be quiet, I must concentrate. I see a vision before me.
As Serana walks around behind him, tapping her foot.
Of a great bow. I know this weapon. It is Oriole's bow. Now a voice whispers, saying, among the knight's children,
Oriole's bow.
A dread lord will rise.
It's going to start really getting exciting with the storyline now.
Return to the realm of men. Darkness will mingle with light, and the night and the day will be as one. The voice fades and the words begin to shimmer and distort. But wait. There is more here. The secret of the bow's power is written elsewhere. I think there is more to the prophecy, recorded in other scrolls. Yes, I see them now. One contains the ancient secrets of the dragons, and the other speaks of the potency of ancient blood. My vision darkens, and I see no more. To know the complete prophecy, we must have the other two scrolls.
Okay, so basically he's talking about a bow and then two other ones, and we have to go
that
find
was.
Them.
My traitor wife stole one of them away and then disappeared. As for the other, the last that I heard, it was lost in the bowels of a Dwemer ruin. It seems our work is not yet done. I have waited this long, and we are so very close now. I can wait a bit longer.
All right. And now we talk to Serana.
You can't trust a word that comes out of your gun's mouth.
That Moth Priest, Dexie. He said we needed two other Elder Scrolls. I think I know where we can start looking. Didn't want that lot getting wind of it. Especially my father. Ever since he decided to make that prophecy his calling, we kind of drifted apart. I don't even think he sees me as his daughter anymore. I'm just a means to an end.
And here you get a little bit of Serana's story.
You need to find my mother, Valerica. She'll definitely know where it is. And if we're lucky, she actually has it herself. The last time I saw her, she said that she'd go somewhere safe. Somewhere that my father would never search. Other than that, she wouldn't tell me anything. But the way she said it, someplace he would never search. It was cryptic, yet she called attention to it. Maybe. What I can't figure out is why she said it that way. Besides, I can't imagine a single place my father would avoid looking. And he's had all this time, too. Any ideas? Wait, that almost makes sense. I used to help my mother tend a garden in the courtyard here. All of the ingredients for our potions came from there. She used to say that my father couldn't stand the place. Too peaceful. Absolutely. But my mother's not a coward. That is, I don't think we'll actually trip over her there, but it's worth a look.
Okay.
Trust me, I lived here a very long time, and I know every nook and cranny. There's an unused inlet on the northern side of the island that was used by the previous owners to bring supplies into the castle. An old escape tunnel from the castle exits there. I think that's our way in. Come on, it's just around the side.
Okay.
The feast never ends.
My necromancer has actually done this already. So it may go a little bit faster, but part of it's still going to take a while. The soul cairn, which is where we're going. Oh boy. The soul cairn has long been complained about. It takes a long time to go through the soul cairn. Yep, he's up top as usual. Every time I either zone in or out of this area, there's a Dawn Guard scout on the ground and one in the top of the tower. I guess it's going to be that way for a while. That was kind of anticlimactic, don't you think, Selena? But anyway, the soul cairn takes a long time to go through. But it's worth it. I mean, I enjoyed going to the soul cairn. I went in there after two things. I went in there after Serana's mother to get the soul, to get the scroll, and then I also went after a nice special little thing that everyone should want. But we're not going to go there directly. I may actually. There's no place to. I want to store this stuff. So maybe we'll find a place on the other side to store it, because I don't want to go in there fully overburdened. And I can give some stuff to Lydia, but I don't want to hear her bitching. And where is Lydia? Where is Lydia? We're going to need her on the other side of this castle. Well, that's special. Okay. Spend a lot of time looking for Lydia. We'll do it one way or another. But first, we're gonna do some range here, cause it.
Just around this bend.
Yeah. Thanks. Of course, there's guardians here. And anyone who doesn't know, when you come down over there, as you're coming down, you go to the right. These boards will walk you pretty much all the way there. That's something I discovered a while back. Okay.
Where'd you come from?
And I will say that our Templar is headed more and more towards necromancy, because she's going to pick up a lot of summon spells and a lot of stuff like that. There we go. especially in the Soul Cairn, you have an opportunity to you have an opportunity to get some summon spells. Oh yeah, that's the one I killed. So yeah, he's up there. Good shot. But yeah, you'll get some opportunity to get some summon spells going on, and some other stuff. I like the Soul Cairn myself. A lot of people don't care for it, but I like it, and I think it's a good addition to the game. I think it's a good storyline for this. Well, there were two of them up here. All right, come on. Maybe when we zone here, we'll get Lydia back. But there is a lot of running around on the Soul Cairn. There's Lydia. There's a lot of running around, and it's a lot of wide open spaces, and you know, you can get lost. I guarantee you can get lost. All right, let's look into this sack here, and we have four crossbows. We're gonna keep one and have all those axes. All right. And hopefully I'll be able to come back in here and pick these up. But it's gonna be a long time before we get anywhere. It's going to be a long time before we can get anywhere to store stuff, sell stuff, repair stuff, all of that. I don't need the collar or the meat. Not interested in either one. Okay.
What was that?
There's the crazy vampire. Okay. That's light. I'll take it. Oh, yeah. She got kicked out from up there and came down here to get her revenge. At least that's what she said in the journal. She was gonna take over. Yeah, we see how well that worked. Alright, helmet, vampire, golems, don't need them. Alright. There's something I need bloody rags for, I can't remember. I'm gonna take it. Books, of course. No, I don't need non-enchanted boots.
Yes.
Okay. Now we're gonna flip that. That should... Oh. Okay, Serana summoning. And that should open, yes, it opened that. Good.
I did see an enemy.
Where did I see the enemy? Can't recall.
There.
Blood dripping down.
I knew I did something.
Okay. Lots of blood in this castle, of course. I try to gather as many supplies as I can while I'm going through here, too. You'll see at the end. Okay. Now, if we can get him. Yeah. There we go. There's gonna be more than one, though. Maybe. Okay. And we'll flip this lever. That will drop the next bridge down. And we can get out of this. Pretty much all this is you just come through and you gotta... Yeah, that's what I thought. That's her dog. You just come through and you gotta drop the gates and drop the bridges and all that stuff so that you can get to the actual cellar itself. Now, we came in and we took a left. We went that way. Alright, so we go straight across. It was backwards.
This leads out to the courtyard. Just head for the door.
More dogs down there, I guess. All right. Now, once you get out here to the courtyard, there's a puzzle, of course. And you basically just go all over the courtyard looking for the pieces to this sundial. I think there are three or four pieces that we're going to have to find here. But that was one.
Something crests are missing, the dial is escaping. I don't even know the crests could be removed. Maybe my mother's trying to tell us something.
And I do think there's one more, but we're going to see here in a second. I believe at one point you had to go into the doorways, into the towers, to find some of the pieces. But the last time when I came through with my Necromancer, there were none in the towers. It was just pretty much a waste of time to go in the towers. Like I said, we'll see. All right. There's one.
I'm telling you, there's something strange with the moon dial.
Two. Three. There we go. Three pieces. So you just go around the courtyard here. Of course, you're going to do that anyway to get all the flowers and stuff like that. And you'll find all three pieces.
I've never been in those tunnels before.
That's all right, come on. And now we have to go through the catacombs. This in itself takes a little while. Lots of bad guys.
Be careful. I don't know what might be around. We're getting close. I'm sure of it.
Like I said, it's always worth picking up bone meal. Always. Bone meal's good. Very good. And we seem to have lost Lydia again. I think my Necromancer lost her too, and didn't get her back till we got into the Soul Cairn, so we may not see Lydia for a while. And if I'm not mistaken, at one point I believe this quest line you couldn't have companions on it other than Serana. Yeah. Okay, I'm trying to get through this as fast as possible. We probably won't see the Soul Cairn on this video, but we're hopefully going to get to the alchemy lab.
Who's there? I knew I heard something.
And the key is just killing these things as fast as you can and moving on. There'll be a few potions. There's some stuff to loot, but...
Who's there?
Once you get to the Alchemy Lab, there's a lot of stuff to loot. Yeah, you do. I'm not sure exactly how they're detecting me so quickly, but... And there are more out here, because I'm not... There we go, I'm hidden now. I can't remember exactly how many there are. But, I think there's going to be another gargoyle before we get there, maybe. Maybe not. Lots of books. I don't think I need any of them. That's a scroll. I'll take that. And give me this so I can write some scrolls myself.
Sure.
You gotta have quills and ink and paper.
We're getting close. Sure.
But you can write your own scrolls. At least I can. And that's one thing I enjoy about this bow, or any bow actually, if I can stagger them, and, you know, it doesn't matter if they do detect me or not, if I can stagger them, then we can pretty much live through it. That's going to be another gargoyle come to life. Doesn't really work that well, but you know, I still need to get that resto up. I'm gonna go back with my two-hander now. All right. Almost lit him up. All right. Now when I pull the chain, it's gonna open something. I can get those power attacks off every now and then, but I have a little difficulty with that lately. Nothing there. Lots of weapons on the walls. Reverent. Nope, don't need it. And don't really need that one either. I will take your potions all day long. I wasn't planning on doing that, but okay. Really? Come on. Oh, too far. Just comes out this way. Okay. I could have probably picked that from the other side. Alright. Carrying on. I don't need your scale bracers, but thanks anyway. Okay. And sometimes Serana gets stuck in sneak mode. I don't know. That's where we came from. We're gonna go up here, cross over. Seems there were a couple up here. Alright. And this should be where we're going. Well, in a minute. Oh no, I'm sorry. There's a room full of these guys. But we're gonna get there. We're gonna get there. Oh, there he is. Stagger, slice. Thanks for showing up.
I don't think we've reached the top yet. I bet there's some kind of secret passage around here.
The royal, vampire royal arm. I will take it. Yes, yes, I will. Let me see. Candlestick. And that's gonna get us to the top. You defeat the room full of gargoyles, turn the candlestick. Here's the alchemy lab. Alright, we're gonna stop here. In the next video, we'll clear out the alchemy lab and do the ritual, and you'll get to see the soul cairn. Thank you very much for watching. Remember, like, share, subscribe. Any questions or comments, just put them in the comments. Thank you very much.